Hi friends, welcome to Wafa Studies YouTube channel. This is part 23 in Azure Data Factory Real-Time Scenarios playlist. In this video, I am going to discuss about how to send email alert whenever any pipeline fails in Azure Data Factory. So we are going to look this in a practical implementation manner. So let me very quickly theoretically explain you what I am going to do first. So let's assume you have a Azure Data Factory in your project. So this is ADF. So inside this your Azure Data Factory, you will be having a pipelines, right? So this is your pipeline. So these pipelines will do certain task. So if this pipelines fails, so in that case, we usually want to send some email alerts saying like your pipeline failed, this is the error message and all. So to achieve this practically, what I am going to do, this email part I am going to send using Logic App. So that means I am going to create a Logic App which is going to respond with HTTP request. So I create a Logic App which is going to respond with HTTP request and in turn send a email alert. And also this, so we create this, but how to call this HTTP request Logic App in your pipeline? So for that you have something called web activity. So if you have seen my ADF playlist, you know that using web activity you can initiate a API call for your HTTP Logic App or for your HTTP triggered Logic Apps or whatever the process. Not only Logic App, you can use function apps also. So any process. So the basic idea is this process is going to trigger with HTTP request and in turn this process is going to send a email alert. So this is what high level what I am going to do. So let me go to my Azure portal and let's create our Logic App first. So this is my Azure Data Factory. So let me create a new resource here. So first let's try to create a Logic App which is going to respond on HTTP request. So let me search here like Logic App in the under create resource. So once again, okay, so let me select this Logic App consumption type and let me click this create button to create my Logic App. So here I am going to select my resource group. I want my Logic App to be inside this Mahir RG resource group. And then I am going to enter a name for this Logic App as LG email alert. So this is the name I want to give for my Logic App. Okay. And then simply click this review plus create button. This will perform a validation on your settings, whatever you have added before creating the Logic App. So once your validations are successful, this create button will be enabled. And you can hit that create button to create your Logic App. So let me click this create button here to create my Logic App. And you can see here your deployment is initiated. So let's wait for the deployment to complete here. So deployment is in progress. Great, our deployment is completed. So let me click this go to resource button, which will actually directly take me into the Logic App. So I am right now going inside the Logic App. You can see my Logic App name LG email alert. And once you open your Logic App, this is how it appears in the very first time. So again, if you don't know what is Logic App and all, please watch my Logic App playlist in my channel called Wafa Studies. Okay. So here I am going to create a Logic App which is a blank type. So there are some pre-built templates are available. You can use them, but let's create a blank Logic App. That means nothing. A plain canvas will come. Everything you have to do. So this is the Logic App designer where you actually implement your Logic App. So Logic Apps basically works based upon your trigger types. So let me clear this canvas. So how Logic App will work is, if you have a Logic App created, so then what you need to define is for this Logic App, what is the trigger? That means how you are going to call this Logic App or in which scenario you want to run this Logic App. And once that particular scenario or event happens, then Logic App executions will start, and inside the execution you will be defining something called actions. So what you want to perform. So in my case, if you technically think, I need to use HTTP as a trigger type to run my Logic App. And in the action, I have to send email, right? So this is what I have to do. So let me go to my Logic App here now. So here first thing is anytime you have to choose the selector according to your trigger type or according to your action type. So I want my Logic App to respond based upon the HTTP request type, right? So search for the HTTP request or request any keyword. If you use here, all the connectors will available here. So this request is the connector which I have to use. So let's select this request connector. So I have selected the request connector. Now if you observe, this request connector has these many triggers. So whenever any HTTP request is received, I can call my logic app, or whenever a event grid resource event occurs, I can call my logic app. So these are all the triggers available for the request connector. And if you go to actions, so these are all the actions available for that connector. So first step in your logic app is always going to be adding a trigger, right? So I am going to select whenever a HTTP request is received, in that scenario run my logic app. So that is my first step. You can see here, when a HTTP request is received, when you click this, it is going to collapse. When you click this, it is going to expand. So now here, if you scroll down, so here it will generate a URL for you once you complete your implementation, and that URL you have to use inside your Data Factory web activity. And here you have to give the JSON. So from your ADF, whatever you are going to supply, so all those things you have to mention here. So what I am going to do here, so you no need to worry about the syntax, like what to type and all. So click this use sample payload to generate. So that means just technically think like what and all I want to supply in a JSON format. So JSON format means open flower bracket, close flower bracket, and inside it what I am going to do, so maybe I want to pass pipeline name. So like this pipeline name, so whatever the pipeline name I pass, so let's assume this is my pipeline name. So like this, just type some sample JSON, and also I want to supply like error message. So what is the error message? So even I am going to supply this. So I am going to type some dummy value here. Then what is my data factory name, maybe? Okay, so JSON values always have this key value pairs, right, in double quotes, hope everyone knows that. So data factory name, so some dummy value, and then maybe I want to supply my pipeline run ID as well to here. So what is my pipeline run ID? So all these details I am going to supply. So let's think like that. Okay, so this is the sample JSON which I typed right now under the sample JSON payload. So let me copy this into my notepad because I am going to refer this in future as well. So let me paste it here. So once I click done here, what will happen now? Logic app will understand your sample JSON, what you are intend to pass, and according to that it will generate that JSON. So let me click this done here, you will understand. So once I click this done here, see here, it automatically, so here what this is telling is whenever you try to call this logic app using a HTTP URL, then make sure to pass application, this is the JSON, right? So make sure to add this content type header with application/json value. So got it, let it click that. Okay, it's just a indication for you. See here, it added some JSON automatically under this request body, and there is something called type property, which is object, then properties. If you closely observe here, all the values whatever you see here, pipeline error message, so there is a small spelling mistake, let me correct this, pipeline error message, data factory name, all these came directly. So how all these came automatically? Because we tried to type our sample JSON what we want to pass, and the logic app is able to understand that sample JSON, and it generates this entire JSON for you. So this is the format in which you have to tell to logic app, like this is the JSON I am going to pass, like that. Okay, so now we are good with this field as well. And then if you scroll down, in which scenarios you want to, so if you know this APIs and all, there is something called method. So get method, put method, post method, delete method, like that. So what type of method you want to issue so that your logic app will respond to that method or respond to that API call. So if you want to explicitly define that method, you can select this method option from this add parameter. And here, once you select this method, then what will happen? It will ask you to select what is the method type you want to associate with this logic app. So I am going to select put here for now. Even if I don't select this, you see here automatically the URL what you get, it is going to be for the post request only. So even I selected here post, if I don't select here, still it will work for the post method. Okay, so this is done. So we configured our trigger. So we configured like what type of JSON I am going to pass, and we configured what type of HTTP method I am going to use to pass, and everything. So let's minimize this trigger now. So once this HTTP request is received to the logic app, then immediately what you want to do, the next step. So then immediately I want to send an email, right? If you remember, I want to send this email. So what I am going to do here immediately, so I should find a connector which will help me to send email from my Outlook. from my Microsoft account. So what I am going to do, I am going to here search like Outlook maybe. So you no need to remember this, just search the keywords. Automatically designer will give the suggestions here. You can see there is a Office 365 Outlook connector is already available. Our outlook.com connector is available. So if you are working in a corporate world, you will use this. I think I have to use this outlook.com. So let me select this. And then it says, so under this outlook.com connector, you have so many triggers. These many triggers are there and these many actions are there. So the trigger part we already done, right? We want to run this logic app whenever HTTP request is received. So now the action part is remaining. So what I want to do, I want to send an email actually. So let me scroll down here. Let me see if there is any like send email kind of action is available. So let me scroll down. See, there is something called send email. So select this send email. This is the action I want to perform. So once you select it, what it is saying, you have to provide access for this logic app to open your Outlook account and send the emails. So that's why it is asking you to sign in here. Click this sign in button. It is going to prompt you to allow access or something like that. So you need to allow that. So let's wait here. So the prompt is opening here. So once we open, we are going to allow it. Great. You can see this is my Outlook account. So let me type my password. Let me click sign in here. So it is giving you this, like, so all these actions it can perform. So let it be. Let's click yes. Okay, so let's wait for this task to complete here. Great, we can see now what logic app will do. Now it will use my Outlook account to send the emails. So now to whom you want to send the email? So for now, let's assume I want to send the email to my account only. So outlook.com and subject like maybe ADF pipeline failed. So this is what the subject I want to keep in my email. So I am not going to in depth about how to compose the email properly here and all. Okay, because my main intention is just to show you how to send the email. So now here in the body, I want to make sure what is the pipeline name. So because I am passing all those information, right? Pipeline name and what is the error message and what is that ADF name and what is that run ID. So I want to show all this information in my pipeline body. So I typed these labels here. Now after pipeline name, let me play space. Then here, if you scroll down, you will see there is something called, if you click this see more under this dynamic content, from your request body, whatever the properties you have in your request, if you see the notepad, in my request I used pipeline property, error message, data factory, run ID, all those properties are available here. So you need to simply click this property names here. So I selected a pipeline now. So now if you see here, for the pipeline name, pipeline property, then for the error message, I am going to select the error message. Let me select here error message dynamic content. And then for the ADF name, I am going to select ADF name dynamic content. So where is ADF name dynamic content, data factory name. Okay, select it. And then for the run ID, I am going to select my run ID. So this is my run ID. So I selected it. So this is what my email body is going to contain: pipeline name, error message name, data factory name, run ID and all. Okay, so let's click this save button. Once you save this, the logic app is going to be created a URL also for you. If you open this trigger here, you can see the logic app URL as well. So now you can take this URL and issue the HTTP request with the post method that in turn is going to execute this logic app and send the emails. So what I am going to do now, let me go to my data factory. Let me open portal.azure.com in another tab here. And then very quickly try to create a new pipeline and let's try to introduce a intentional failure there. And let's see whether my pipeline captures it or not, whether my logic app sends the email or not. So let me open my data factory, Mahir ADF. Let me click this author and monitor tile here. Let's wait for my Azure data factory to load here. Okay, so our data factory studio opened. So let me go to this author pencil icon here and let's create a new pipeline. And inside this new pipeline, what I am going to do, let me do this. Let me use a copy activity maybe. On a copy activity, let's try to introduce one manual error. So I am going to create a data set here. For my blob storage maybe, and I will select a path or file which is not there. So let me select this delimited text. I have already a linker service for my blob storage. Let me browse the location. So I am going to select a path now which is not there in my blob storage, so that right if I try to perform the copy, it is going to give some error. So under ADF demo container data folder, there is no abcd.csv file, right? So what I am going to do, I am going to click OK here, and here I am going to say abcd.csv file. So this file is not at all there. So let me click no need to take the schema. Let me click OK. So this creates your source data set. Now let me go to sync and let me select some data set which is pointing to output folder. That is fine. So if you see this source, if I open this data set, so it is pointing to abcd.csv file, which is not there. So technically my pipeline is going to fail actually. So let me run this before doing anything else and see whether my pipeline fails or not, and then let's add a let's invoke after this logic copy activity fail logic app and try to send a email. So let's wait for this execution to complete. Here you can see your pipeline is failed, and if you see the error message, it says blob, the required blob is missing, right? So that path is missing, that's what it is. So now my pipeline failed, my activity failed. So now I want to send a email alert. So what I can do, I can add a control flow on failure. I can go and call my web activity, because web activity will help you to send the email alerts. Red color means on failure, and here in the web activity, if I go to settings, so here I have to paste that logic app URL. I pasted it. Then as I said, this real along with this URL, we have to pass a method. Which method it is? So let me post, because we selected post right there. And then if you remember, when we are creating a logic app, it says pass a header type called content type, and value should be application/json. Okay, and here this is where the request body. So this is where you need to pass this JSON. You need to pass what is your pipeline name, what is your error message, what is your data factory name, what is your run ID, all this information you need to pass in this JSON format under that request body. So let me copy this here, and then let me open this dynamic content and let me paste it here. See, I am passing it here, but here this pipeline name and all should not be hard coded. So what I can do here, remove this hard coded value, and if I go to system variables, this there will be a system variable called pipeline name that will give, see, select this. So if you see this will give the pipeline. So this is the system variable which will give your pipeline name. So you need to add this @colon so like this you need to add. So again here error message, so @openflowerbracket, in middle you need to pass the expression. So it is a copy activity failure, right? So go to copy activity here, and on the copy activity output dot, on this output there is something called error property and then message property. So if you use this, it is going to give you the error message. So how I am going to say on the out, so you need to remove this output also. So I have explained already this in my past videos. So if you go to Wafa Studies YouTube channel, under Wafa Studies YouTube channel, in Azure Data Factory Tips and Tricks playlist, in part 2 I have explained that, so please watch that. So here let's pass the data factory name @ open flower bracket close flower bracket, in middle you need to pass the expression. So here there will be a system variable available for your data factory name, so let me select that, and then for the run ID also there will be a system variable available, so let me pass that as well here. So run ID, you can see pipeline run ID. Okay, so this is how you need to pass it. Okay, and it says there is something invalid, right? Why? Because there is @ here appended, we need to remove that. So this is all. Now we added our request JSON in a dynamic fashion. So we used this string interpolation syntax, @ open flower bracket close flower bracket, and middle we passed our expressions which will return our pipeline names, copy activity failure message, data factory name, pipeline run ID. Simply click this finish button now, and now let's try to run this pipeline and see whether it is going to call our logic app, and in turn we are going to receive our email or not. So let's wait here for the execution to complete. You can see copy activity failed, and if you see the web activity, and if you go to input JSON, see the input JSON, pipeline name is pipeline 3, error messages, you can see the entire error message here, and also you can see data factory name is Mahir ADF, and run ID, see everything is properly getting passed, right? and let me close this. And web activity is also executed successfully. Let me go to my email box. You can see I got an email here. The subject is ADF pipeline failed, and see pipeline 3 is failed, and the error message details is here. And what is the data factory name? The data factory name is Mahir ADF. And what is the run ID? This is the run ID. See, I automatically got an email, right? So how all this magic happened? Because of the logic app. We created a logic app which is going to respond for the HTTP request type and send the email alert. And in the email alert, in the email body, we use this dynamic content here to populate this pipeline names, error message, data factory name, and everything. And how logic app is knowing all this pipeline name, error message, and everything? Because in this HTTP trigger type itself, we added all these properties saying if anyone is going to issue a HTTP request for this logic app, they have to supply these values. And how we are supplying these values? From the web activity, in the request body JSON here, we used these expressions to get those values dynamically into our logic app. So hope this gives a clear idea how you actually create a process which is going to respond to HTTP request and send the email alerts to you, right? And that HTTP request process you actually added into your pipeline using a web activity and calling that web activity on failure. So hope this given a clear idea like how to call or how to send an email whenever your pipeline fails. So not only for failure scenarios, in any case you can do this. I taken failure scenario as an example only. So you can do this logic app implementation for any scenario and send the alerts. Simply use a web activity to call that logic app. So because you are going to create a logic app which is going to respond for HTTP request, right? Okay. So hope you like this video. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.